Let's kick it off with Russia. We probably should. How does this play into the whole investor sentiment piece for you now in Europe generally?
I think it really is still a cause for concern at the moment. Putin is doing his best now to make a bad situation look good or at least manageable. But I think we're very much concerned that the problems we're seeing in Russia are still going to spill over into Europe in the rest of 2014 and certainly into 2015. You've got major issues for Germany and other exporting economies if you've got Russia not functioning very well. And the danger of political turmoil as the pressure continues to be piled on the Kremlin is still acute.
Do we take what Putin says today with a pinch of salt? Do we watch this with a sense of amusement?
A sense of maybe more foreboding, I think, is the worry. This is a man that thought he was very much in control of the crisis he had created this year with the Ukraine. And now it seems to be slipping from his control. The fall in oil, of course, was something he probably never dreamed of would happen in his wildest nightmares. And now he finds himself in a situation where actually the economy in which he thought was fairly secure and could withstand Western sanctions is now beginning to slip away beneath his feet. So I think the risk is of backing him into a corner with further sanctions. And we know that's what Western Europe are doing. And if they push him too far, we're worried about the consequences.
We've had the EFO, as I mentioned, looks pretty good. I mean, it's so temperamental what's going on right now, it seems, given good numbers, bad numbers, ECB woes, etc., etc. What's your feeling generally about the Eurozone economy? Can the meeting, the summit today, calm any fears over the Eurozone?
I think if this Eurozone summit decided anything in particular, it would be a marked departure from the norm for them, because of course a lot of fine talk but not much action to go with it. Of course, that's very similar to what the ECB does at the moment. But I think the improvement in German figures over the last couple of months, as we saw in that EFO reading, is based primarily on the idea that the ECB is going to take some sort of action in 2015 or at some point in the new year. And that is going to be the main reassuring element. And if that sort of drops off the agenda, we could see a rapid return to the poor run of economic data.
Is Jean-Claude Juncker's investment plan anything to write home about?
I suggest, again, it's a plan, it's an impressive plan, but again, it's the implementation, and Eurozone record in implementation is not the best in the world particularly.
Quick word on Greece, your reaction to last night's vote?
It's a welcome sign. I think it's interesting the fact that we've got the vote developing in that way, but there's probably more to come, really. This sort of turmoil in Greece is not a one-episode event. There's always more lurking behind the curtain. I think we should be very concerned that the situation will worsen further into the new year.